From Crema Media in Johannesburg, this is the Real Economy Report. The first phase of the 1.5 billion rand Forest Hill City shopping mall in Monavoni in Centurion was launched last month by property developers Billion Group, with the entire development set for a grand opening on July 10. Sashnee Moodley was there.
The Forest Hill City shopping mall development, located along the N14 and R55 highways, consists of 75,000 square meters of residential, restaurant and retail space and features 190 stores. The project developer, Billion Group founder and CEO Sisa Ngebulana, says the development is the first of its kind for the region, as it had previously lacked sufficient retail facilities, which resulted in a longer commute for local residents. He adds that the development is also a catalyst for City Precinct.
The mall is a catalyst for something bigger here. Total development here is about 10 billion in value terms. So the mall probably about 1.6 billion in value terms. It's a catalyst for a city precinct. So what we did, we did research. We found out that this area is, we've owned this land for the last 12 years. It was strategic for us when we acquired it because we could see the growth coming this way. This has taken over 15 months. So they started this project about 1st of March last year, construction. So what you see here, even though it's incomplete, there's a section on the entertainment that still carries on, which is the next phase. And that's due to complete in a month time from now, effectively. So we have a grand opening on the 10th of July. That'll be following the completion of those sections. It'll have the biggest ice rink, Olympic-sized ice rink, where we can have ice hockeys besides ice skating and those sort of things, and other activities within that are ice-related. We'll have a wave pool where teenagers will surf. You only have Gateway currently in the country, but this one is better than Gateway because it'll have warm water, which relies on reverse cycle with the ice rink, because ice rink needs cold, it needs warm. So they work together in producing that. So it doesn't consume more electricity than it should.
The Billion Group has spent more than 100 million on road infrastructure and has created job opportunities for residents in the surrounding area. More than a million shoppers are expected at the mall each month.
As you said, you had 6,000 jobs during construction. You got 2,500 jobs permanently created. Just for this, and then you have another potentially 10,000 jobs for the rest of the precinct, which is quite something for this community. And obviously the roads, expanded roads. We've expanded loops on the highway. We've got expanded R55 and Marais Road that comes off the R55, which will kick off the entire area with street lighting, and which is quite good for the area.
The city of Shawnee Mayo welcomed the investment and noted that the economic activity generated in the area will generate jobs and catalyze further development in the southwest of Pretoria.
On the economic front, we are able to generate multiple employment opportunities for people who were previously unemployed. So it's significant because it means that they were able to put bread on the table and they were able to increase consumption at the household level. And it's also significant because it's adjoining a low-income development that is Olivan Oudtshoorn. So I'm sure that the people of Olivan, a significant majority of the people who are employed here, will serve as the catchment area will be from Olivan. So that's the one side. On the economic side is that we are beginning to see that economic growth has got geographic traction. We needed a development of this magnitude, of this size, to the west of the city so that we can catalyze development along the R55 and the N14 corridor. And this is what it does. So I'm optimistic that you are likely going to see other industry following. You are likely going to see other people seizing new opportunities that are associated with a development of this magnitude. So it's significant on that front. It's also significant because invariably we needed to improve the road infrastructure around access, connectivity, and at the developers' cost, they've been able to do that. So suddenly, we are not just using these roads to access this opportunity, but you use it for purposes of mobility. So we're happy as a city that we're able to grow the city and take it forward. And I think it's a sign of what the confidence of the private sector on the leadership of the city one. Two, that the city has been able to create an environment that enables easy investment by developers. I mean, one of the things that we had to do was to fight many legal battles that were trying to halt this development. And very early on in those battles, we were on the side of the developer because we understood the magnitude and the impact of the that this development will have on the city. And yes, it's also changing the city's skyline. It's changing the city's personality to the west. So we're excited. I think there are greater things to come going forward.
Other news making headlines this week, Telkom gains traction in stabilizing the group, and AXA's new app puts the airport in the pocket of passengers. Embattled telecommunications group Telkom has gained some traction in its attempt to return the group to sustainability and prepare itself for a challenging future.
We started what we call a turnaround for Telkom, and we think that the early steps are beginning to show some positive results. The cost transformation program is beginning to show some early successes, but you know, it is not a one-off thing. You know, costs and what we need to do around how we manage them, it's a multi-year program, and actually we have evolved a multi-year cost efficiency program which will enable us to have a much stronger DNA in terms of how we manage our costs going forward.
After indicating its intention to shift to a more customer-centric operating model, Airports Company South Africa recently unveiled phase one of its pioneering free airport application or app, which will enable passengers to easily navigate any of its 9 airports and make or amend air travel arrangements using their smartphones.
When customers talk to us, and we see it every single day, is that they prefer to use mobile and social media. Travelers want to be more in control. They want more comfort. They want to feel more secure. They also want personalization. And with technology, we can achieve it. So our objective with the app was really to streamline and personalize the airport journey for passengers that's more empowered than ever before. We want to keep customers connected, and we want to do it one click at a time.
That's Creamer Media's Real Economy Report. Join us again next week for more news and insight into South Africa's real economy.